The engineering challenges faced by Stone Age builders were staggering. Imagine trying to construct a sturdy, weather-resistant home using only rocks, sticks, and whatever natural materials you could find. No nails, no screws, no metal brackets, no level to ensure walls are straight, no measuring tape to ensure components fit together. Every joint had to be crafted by hand. Every measurement had to be eyeballed. Every structural decision had to be based on intuitive understanding of forces and materials. Yet archaeological evidence shows that Stone Age peoples routinely created structures that stood for decades, even centuries. From the megalithic stone houses of Northern Europe to the sophisticated timber frame buildings of early agricultural settlements, our ancestors developed construction techniques that were not only effective, but often superior to later methods. The story begins with the most fundamental challenge. How do you cut and shape building materials without metal tools? The answer reveals one of humanity's most underappreciated innovations, controlled fracture technology. At sites like Boxgrove in England, dating to 500,000 years ago, archaeologists have found evidence of sophisticated stoneworking techniques that could produce construction materials with remarkable precision. The key was understanding how different materials break under stress. For stone construction, early builders learned to read the grain structure of rocks like geologists. They could identify natural fracture planes and use controlled pressure to split stones along predictable lines. At Skara Brae in Scotland, dating to 3200 BCE, excavations revealed that Neolithic builders had split massive sandstone slabs with such precision that the joints between stones are nearly invisible. The tools used for this precision stone work were deceptively simple, but required enormous skill to master. Stone hammers weighing 10 to 15 pounds were used to deliver controlled impacts. Wooden wedges, driven into natural cracks and then soaked with water, could split even massive stones as the wood expanded. Bronze Age builders discovered that heating stones with fire and then rapidly cooling them with water could create controlled fractures that followed predictable patterns. But stone splitting was just the beginning. Shaping stones for construction required techniques that bordered on artistic mastery. Archaeological experiments have shown that skilled Stone Age masons could create perfectly fitted joints using only stone tools and an intuitive understanding of geometry. The secret was a process called pecking and grinding, systematically removing tiny chips of stone until the desired shape emerged. At sites like Newgrange in Ireland, dating to 3200 BCE, researchers found evidence of construction techniques that wouldn't be out of place in a modern engineering manual. The massive stones used in the tomb's construction were shaped to precise curves and angles, with joints so tight that no mortar was needed. Analysis of tool marks shows that individual stones required hundreds of hours of careful shaping, yet the final result was architectural precision that rivals modern work. Wood construction presented different challenges, but equally sophisticated solutions. Without metal saws, how do you cut timber to precise lengths? The answer was controlled burning, a technique that required enormous skill and patience. At sites like Kalambo Falls in Zambia, dating to 300,000 years ago, archaeologists found evidence of wooden tools shaped entirely through controlled burning and scraping. The process began with selecting appropriate trees based on species, size, and grain structure. Different wood types required different approaches. Softwoods could be shaped more quickly, but were less durable, while hardwoods required more time, but produced superior construction materials. Once a tree was felled, usually through a combination of fire weakening and stone chopping, the real engineering began. Shaping timber required understanding wood's internal structure at an almost cellular level. Early builders learned that wood could be split along its grain with remarkable precision using wooden wedges and stone hammers. They discovered that heating wood made it more pliable and easier to bend into desired shapes. At waterlogged sites in Northern Europe, archaeologists have recovered wooden building components that show evidence of sophisticated joining techniques. The joinery methods developed by Stone Age builders were marvels of engineering ingenuity. Without nails or metal fasteners, every joint had to rely on mechanical connections and the careful shaping of wood itself. The most common technique was the mortise and tenon joint, where a projecting piece of wood, the tenon, fits into a corresponding hole, the mortise. Creating these joints with stone tools required extraordinary precision. Archaeological evidence from sites like the Somerset Levels in England shows that Neolithic builders had mastered dozens of different joint types. Lap joints connected horizontal beams. Dovetail joints created permanent connections that grew stronger under stress. And scarfing joints allowed builders to create long beams from shorter pieces. Each joint type required specific tools and techniques, representing a sophisticated understanding of structural engineering. The tools used for precision woodworking were specialised instruments that took years to master. Stone adzes, shaped like small axes, but with the blade perpendicular to the handle, could remove precise amounts of wood with each stroke. Flint knives with carefully shaped edges could pare wood to exact dimensions. Bone awls could punch precise holes for wooden pins and wedges. But the most remarkable tool was the human eye and hand working together. Experiments with master craftspeople have shown that experienced woodworkers can achieve tolerances of less than a millimeter using only hand tools and visual guidance. Stone Age builders developed this same level of precision through years of practice and apprenticeship systems that ensured knowledge was passed down accurately. Foundation construction required solving problems that modern engineers still struggle with. How do you create level, stable foundations without surveying equipment or concrete? The answer was a combination of careful site selection and ingenious levelling techniques. At sites like Çatalhöyük in Turkey, dating to 7500 BCE, archaeologists found evidence of foundation systems that distributed building loads across unstable soils. The key was understanding soil mechanics through direct observation and experience. Stone Age builders learned to identify stable soil types, understand drainage patterns, and predict how different materials would behave under load. They developed techniques for improving poor soils through drainage, compaction, and the addition of stabilizing materials like gravel and sand. Leveling foundations without modern instruments required ingenious solutions. One common technique involved using water-filled trenches to establish level reference lines. Builders would dig shallow channels around the construction site and fill them with water. Since water always seeks the same level, these channels provided accurate horizontal references that could guide foundation construction. Another sophisticated technique involved using weighted strings to establish plumb lines and level references. Archaeological evidence shows that Stone Age builders understood basic geometric principles and could use simple tools to create accurate right angles and level surfaces. At sites like Stonehenge, the precision of stone placement suggests surveying techniques that rival modern methods. Wall construction presented unique challenges that required understanding structural forces and material properties. Load-bearing walls had to support not only their own weight, but also the weight of roofs and any upper stories. Without steel reinforcement or modern concrete, every wall was essentially a gravity structure that depended on careful design and construction. Stone walls required understanding how different stones would interact under load. Builders learned to select stones based on their structural properties, placing harder stones at stress points and using softer stones where flexibility was beneficial. The technique of dry stone construction, building without mortar, required extraordinary skill in stone selection and placement. Each stone had to be individually fitted, with its weight and shape contributing to the overall structural integrity. Master builders could look at a pile of random stones and visualize how they would fit together into a stable wall. This three-dimensional puzzle solving required spatial intelligence that few modern people possess. Timber frame construction required different but equally sophisticated skills. Wooden posts and beams had to be sized and positioned to handle structural loads without failure. Stone Age builders developed empirical rules for beam sizing based on span and load requirements. They understood that deeper beams were stronger than wider ones and that wood grain orientation affected strength properties. the most impressive Stone Age structures combined multiple building techniques into integrated systems. At sites like Poverty Point in Louisiana, dating to 1700 BCE, archaeologists found evidence of massive earthwork constructions that required moving millions of cubic yards of soil without wheeled vehicles or large domesticated animals. The engineering required for these projects rivaled anything accomplished in the ancient world. Roof construction was perhaps the most challenging aspect of Stone Age building. Roofs had to shed water, support their own weight, and resist wind forces, all while using only natural materials and hand tools. The solutions developed by our ancestors were remarkably sophisticated and varied by region and available materials. In areas with abundant timber, builders developed truss systems that distributed roof loads across multiple support points. These early trusses used the same geometric principles as modern roof structures, creating triangular frameworks that were both strong and lightweight. The joints in these trusses required extraordinary precision to ensure that loads were properly distributed. In regions where timber was scarce, builders developed alternative roofing systems using stone slabs, bundled reeds, or earth. The famous turf roofs of Iceland and Scandinavia trace their origins to Stone Age techniques for creating waterproof and insulating roof systems using local materials. Waterproofing presented constant challenges for Stone Age builders. Without modern materials like tar or rubber, they had to develop weatherproofing techniques using natural materials. Archaeological evidence shows that builders used tree resins, animal fats, and specially prepared plant fibres to create water-resistant barriers. The most sophisticated waterproofing systems involved multiple layers of different materials, each serving a specific function. Outer layers shed the bulk of precipitation. Middle layers provided backup protection and insulation, while inner layers managed any moisture that penetrated the outer defences. Quality control in Stone Age construction relied on community oversight and master craftsman systems. Unlike modern construction, where inspectors check work against written codes, Stone Age building quality was maintained through apprenticeship systems and community involvement. Master builders trained apprentices through years of hands-on experience, ensuring that construction knowledge was preserved and refined across generations. Archaeological evidence suggests that major construction projects were community efforts involving dozens of people with specialized skills. Toolmakers provided the implements needed for construction, while specialists in different materials, stone, wood, earth, thatch, contributed their expertise to different aspects of the project. The durability of Stone Age construction is attested by the many prehistoric structures that survive today. Stonehenge, Newgrange, Skara Brae, and thousands of other Stone Age buildings have survived for millennia, despite having been built without metal tools or modern materials. This longevity reflects not just good materials, but sophisticated understanding of structural engineering and construction techniques. Modern engineers studying these ancient structures are often amazed by their sophistication. The precision of fit, the understanding of structural forces, and the integration of multiple building systems rival anything accomplished with modern tools. In many cases, Stone Age construction techniques prove superior to modern methods in terms of durability and environmental appropriateness. Perhaps most remarkably, all of this was accomplished using what we would consider the most basic tools. No power equipment, no precision measuring instruments, no manufactured fasteners or structural components. Every element was shaped by hand using stone, wood, and bone tools that the builders made themselves. The knowledge required for Stone Age construction was encyclopedic. Master builders had to understand geology, forestry, structural engineering, materials science, and construction management. They had to be able to visualize complex three-dimensional structures and coordinate the work of multiple specialists. They combined the skills of architect, engineer, contractor, and craftsman into a single individual. The techniques developed by Stone Age builders continued to influence construction for thousands of years. Many traditional building methods used until the Industrial Revolution trace their origins directly to Stone Age innovations. Timber framing, dry stone construction, earth building, and thatching all preserved ancient knowledge systems that had proven their effectiveness across millennia. Today, as modern builders struggle with sustainability and environmental impact, there's renewed interest in Stone Age construction techniques. Natural building movements, green architecture, and disaster-resistant construction all draw inspiration from methods first developed by our tool-making ancestors. The story of Stone Age engineering is ultimately a testament to human problem-solving ability. Faced with the fundamental challenge of creating shelter, using only natural materials and the most basic tools, our ancestors developed solutions that were not only effective, but often superior to modern alternatives. They proved that the most sophisticated tool of all is the human mind applied to practical problems. When we see a Stone Age structure like Stonehenge or Newgrange, we're not just looking at an ancient building. We're seeing evidence of engineering knowledge, construction skills, and organisational abilities that rival anything we can accomplish today. These monuments stand as permanent testimony to the ingenuity of people who had no tools but made no excuses.